What's up, everybody? Welcome back to my channel for a new Let's Play. As you can see, we are playing Jak and Daxter The Precursor Legacy, which, I must say, is probably one of my favorite games ever made. Definitely in my top 5, definitely top 3. Not quite sure if it's number 1 or not. It kind of goes back and forth between this and Ratchet and Clank. But yeah, I absolutely love this game. It's made by my favorite game dev company, which is Naughty Dog. Definitely one of the games I have the most memories playing as a kid. Let's just select a save state real quick and then get right into it.
I have spent my life searching for the answers that my father and my father's fathers failed to find. Who were the precursors? Why did they create the vast monoliths that litter our planet? How did they harness eco, the life energy of the world? What was their purpose? And why did they vanish? I have asked the plants, but they do not remember. The plants have asked the rocks, but the rocks do not recall. Even the rocks do not recall. Every bone in my body tells me that the answers rest on the shoulders of a young boy. Oblivious to his destiny, uninterested in the search for truth, and rejecting of my guidance. And why would he want to listen to old Samus the Sage anyway? I'm only the master of green ego, one of the wisest men on the planet. So it seems the answer begins not with careful research or sensible thinking. Nay, as with many of fate's mysteries, it begins with but a small act of disobedience.
Jack, old green stuff told us not to come here.
Continue your search for artifacts, Aniko. If the locals possess precursor items, you know what to do.
Deal harshly with anybody who strays from the village. We will attack it in due time.
What are we doing here anyway, Jack? This place gives me the creeps. Huh? Oh, stupid precursor junk. Eek! What is that dark ooze? It sure don't look friendly. The sage yaps on about the precursors that built this place all the time.
Where did they go? Why did they build this crud?
Now, I like precursor orbs and power cells as much as the next guy. But if you ask me, they must have been real losers. Wow! How did you do that? I think we're in trouble! Man, that stung! I told you we shouldn't have come here, and you listened! What? I'm fine.
What in green tarnation do you two want?
I was...
Don't tell me! Instead of heeding my wisdom, the two of you went mucking around in the only place that I told you not to go. Misty Island.
That's right! And then...
And, Daxter, you finally took a much-needed bath, but in a bathtub filled with dark eco.
Look, old man! Are you gonna keep yapping? Or are you gonna help me out of this mess?
I'm gonna keep yapping, because in my professional opinion, the change is an improvement. And besides, I couldn't help you if I wanted to.
What?
There's only one person who has studied Dark Eco long enough to have a chance at returning you to your previous form. Gal Acheron, the Sage. But he lives far to the north. Far, far to the north. Nobody has spoken to him in ages. I would teleport you there, but I can't do that either. None of the three sages that maintain the other teleporter gates have seen fit to turn their ends on for quite a while. The only other way north is by foot through the Fire Canyon, but its volcanic soil is hot enough to melt precursor metal. You can't just walk through it.
But you could fly over it if you had a zoomer equipped with a heat shield. I just happen to be working on such a thing at this very moment. All I would need is 20 power cells to give it enough energy to withstand the canyon's heat. Isn't that right, Daddy?
Yes, Kira, that might work. But where are a boy and a half going to get 20 power cells?
From the villagers. Most of them have a power cell or two stashed away somewhere. And even if they aren't willing to just give them away, greasing their palms with a few precursor orbs should do the trick. And I bet there are even more of them out in the wilds just waiting for some brave adventurer to find.
Well, we've got the brave adventurer at least.
Brave adventurer? You two couldn't find your way out of the village without training. Before you do anything else, you better go through the warp gate and get some practice on Geyser Rock.
We won't find any more of that dark gooey eco stuff, will we? 'Cause I'd hate to fall in again and turn into you.
Get in there! Before I turn you both into ferns!
All right.
You can't come back to the warp gate until you find all four power cells on this island.
This device...
All right. Before we do anything, I forgot to do this. I'm going to turn the subtitles on. If it allows me. Is the game options. Graphics? I might have to do it the main menu. I don't know. I thought for sure that I could do that.
With it, my father and I can give you advice at any time during your quest.
Alright. So to begin, these are kind of the main, like, I guess kind of currency of the game. Little precursor orbs.
These floating egg-shaped things are precursor orbs. Collect enough of them, and some of the villagers will give you a power cell in exchange.
I guess I don't have to explain it. But, yeah, so these are the things that you're gonna see the most in this game, I would say. And then, if you go here, on the right side, you can see all the different kind of collectibles. So we got the precursor orbs right here, we got the power cells right here, and then we got the, flying scout traps, I think is what it's called? I played it in a while, so I don't know. And yeah, anyways, I absolutely love this game. The gameplay, the movement, the story, the humor, everything, it's just perfect.
This is a power cell, the most important precursor artifact you can find. You need to collect 20 of these so I can power the heat shield for your A-Grab Zoomer.
Also, I don't think I said it, but I'm playing this on PS5 right now. You can download it if you have like the PlayStation Plus thing. It's not the HD collection, unfortunately, but yeah, we will be 100%ing this game and platinuming it.
One of my scout flies. I sent 7 of them to each area to look for power cells, but the workers must have captured them all.
Yeah, so these are scout flies. To my knowledge, I think this is the only way you can destroy them with just Jak. Later, there'll be somewhere you can destroy you when you're on like vehicles and stuff, so you just like run into it. But for now, we'll just do this. You collect 7 and you get a power cell. And once again, you can go here, press square, and it'll give you the list of all of them. These two are grayed out, meaning we don't know what they are. We'll just go back.
Scout each area, you can find even more power cells.
That's Blue Eco, which contains the energy of motion. Blue Eco allows you to run fast, break boxes, and even activate some precursor artifacts when you get near them.
Alright. Let's grab this, and we can collect some from further away and run a lot faster. Before I do anything else, I'm just going to use this to do what we're supposed to do with it. Just get over here and open up the door. Oh wait, it stopped me.
This is a precursor door. It can only be opened by approaching the door while channeling Blue Eco through your body.
Did it. Okay, now I ran out. There's some more over there at that little thing, but I'm gonna backtrack a little bit. I don't remember everything about this game, so I don't remember if there are any precursor orbs or anything over here. Might as well check. Okay, there definitely are. I just like ran past. Always gotta check out the little corner so you don't miss anything. I believe this level is like 50 precursor orbs. I know I checked, but I didn't actually check the number. Alright. And back in the day when the HD collection came out on the PS3, I would say probably the biggest Let's Play was someone called the COD Brothers, which they'd now go by like Super Saiyan Paul or something along those lines. He changes his name quite a bit. But yeah, very enjoyable to watch. But he said that this Blue Eco and stuff was very influenced by like Dragon Ball.
Blue Eco vent. More concentrated than the floating clusters. This vent will give you a full charge of Blue Eco, letting you use it for the maximum time.
Is it the Eco or just like his hair and kind of style and stuff? I don't know. Anyways, it's still cool. If you want a enjoyable Let's Play to watch this after you watch mine, of course, I would definitely go check his out, his original one. He's played through it many times. They're all pretty good. He just knows a lot more about this game than I do. Let's go. We got our first power cell and our first trophy. Me up. Okay, let's crouch and then jump to get a higher jump just to make sure we get all those orbs.
Those little green balls of energy on the ground are a type of eco. Pick up 50 small green ecos or one big green one to increase your health.
Let's go. And then I honestly don't remember. I believe there's different kind of ecos in this game. There's this green eco, the blue eco, and then I believe a red eco. Oh, red eco, and then a orange eco or something. Yellow eco, I think. Actually, I think it's yellow. Yeah, but we won't be seeing those till a little bit later.
You can jump once, then jump again in the air to reach even higher ledges.
Let's go. We got 50, which we don't get a power cell. And then we get this power cell, which might be our last one, actually. I have not been keeping track, to be honest.
I'm just happy to be playing this run around and play as Jack.
All right, then we could collect this and then activate this little elevator back down. But yeah, let me know what you guys think of the game so far. I absolutely love this game. Like I said, it's top three, like tied for first between this and Ratchet and Clank Going Commando. And yeah, I don't know if there's anything else for me to say, so if you enjoyed this video, please feel free to leave a like, comment, and subscribe. Thank you for watching. Now let's go say hi to all of our friends.
Good training, boys, but that's nothing compared to the challenges that lie ahead.
Then no problem. We got the moves, eh, Jack? We'd love to stay in chat, Big Green, but we're itching to get on with our adventures.
Fine, fine. Adventure away, then. And while you're out adventuring, why don't you make yourself useful? My darn green eco-collectors are clogged up again. Head out to the far side of the beach and clear them out, why don't you? Follow the lamps. They'll take you right there. Now, all of you, get out of here!